In shallah, today we'll study three types of mad. But first, we will have to do some revision because it's important to revise all the tajweed rules. First of all, we talked about the etiquettes or the adab of recitation, and the most important thing that we mentioned is devotion and sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following the Prophet path alayhi salatu wassalam, and the Islamic hygiene. Be clean yourself, having wudu, and all of the etiquettes that we talked about. The second thing we were talking about was accidental sukoon. When you stop on a letter, you give it sukoon because you stop on it in pronunciation. And the third one is dental letters or the tongue letters or al-huruf al-lithawiyya, which is tha, tha, and dha. You need to stick your tongue between your upper and lower teeth. Then we studied the ghunna letters, or the letters you make ghunna two counts with. They are noon and meem with shadda. The shadda is two letters are merged together. The first one has sukoon and the second one has vowel, as we see here. Then lam shamsiya and lam qamariya. Sometimes you pronounce the lam like the word al-ard, and sometimes you just merge it like the word as-suhuf. You pronounce the lam, which is lam qamariya, if it is followed by one of these letters, abghi hajjaka wa khaf aqimahu, and it's called al lam al qamariya, and the sign that you find a real sukoon above the lam, and it's pronounced. Al lam shamsiya is a merged lam with nothing above it, and the next letter has shadda, and it will be from the category apart from abghi hajjaka wa khaf aqimahu, which are the remaining letters of alphabet of Arabic. Then al-qalqala, simple and easy, the bouncy sound or the echo sound. You do it with letters qutub ajad when they have sukoon, either sukoon asli, the original sukoon, when they have sukoon above them, or sukoon ard when you stop on them. Then noon sakina and tanween has four rules. The first one is making them clear with al-idhar, with throat letters, which are hamza, ha, ayn, ha, ghayn, kha. You need to make the sound of noon sakina and the sound of tanween clear. The second thing with noon sakina and tanween is merging or al-idgham with the letters yarmuluna or yarmaluna. And yarmaluna is two categories. The first one is doing the idgham or merging with two counts ghunna with the letters yanmu. And the second one is merged with no ghunna with letters lam and ra. And there are four vocabs in the Quran. You don't do idgham, they are exceptions. Dunya, Bunyan, Qinwan, and Sinwan, or in other words, if idgham comes in one word, it won't be any idgham. Then al-iqlab is switching noon sakina or tanween to meme. Then you hide this meme with two counts ghunna. In other words, you will leave very little space between your two lips, our upper and lower lips, with doing two ghunna with letter ba. Al-Ikhfa, which is hiding, is the third and last one of Nun Sakina and Tanween rule. And the letters of Al-Ikhfa is the remaining letters apart from Idgham, Izhar, and Iqlab letters. You do Ikhfa, you hide the Nun with two counts Gunna. Yanqubuna naran falamma min thamari. Then the heaviness and lightness is very important rule. And as we said, 80% of anybody's mistakes come from this rule. The heavy letters are khussa, baatin, qidh. And we have some details in lam and ra. Lam is always light except for the word Allah if there is dhamma or fatha before it, like inna allaha and nasrullahi. But if there is kasra before the word Allah, he do it light. Apart from this detail, the lamb always light. To summarize the rule of the ra is heavy when there is fatha or dhamma or the category of fatha or dhamma above it. And if it has sukoon, you check the letter before it. If it has fatha or dhamma, it's heavy. In all of these cases, fatha and dhamma categories, ra is heavy. It's light with the kasra category. And if there is hamzatul wasl before, the ra is going to be heavy as well. The highest level of heaviness is when the heavy letter comes with alif mad, and the weakest one is when the heavy letter comes with kasra. The merging rule or idgham is coming when there is a letter with no vowels and next letter has shadda. You need to merge. Meem sakinah is easy. It has three cases. The first one is hide in ba, merge in meem, and they are both with two counts gunna, and make it clear with the remaining letters. Then hamzatul wasl is an alif with a little sad above it. You drop it when you are connecting recitation, like kul id'u, but if you start with it, you need to pronounce it. Sometimes you pronounce it with fatha if it is followed by lam. You pronounce hamzatul wasl always with fatha. And if it is not followed by lam, you check the third letter. If the third letter has dhamma, then hamzatul wasl is going to be with dhamma. If the third letter has kasra or fatha, then hamzatul wasl will be with fatha. Here is the rule of today, which is al-mudud, which is extensions, or when do you stretch your voice. Let's just practice, then inshallah we'll take three rules of al-mud today, inshallah. Nasiran, nasiran, mahmudu, mahmudu, sa'idun, sa'idun, as-samaa, ma anzal. كاف ها يا عين صاد طه الضالين العالمين ضبح آمنوا إنه هو عذابه أحد. المدود, as you see, it's a lot of categories, but we will inshallah talk about three ones of today, which is al-mad al-tabi'i, natural mad, al-mad al-muttasil, the connected mad, al-mad al-munfasil, the disconnected mad. Al-mad al-tabi'i is easy. The letters of mad al-tabi'i are waw, alif, and ya, and there are some conditions with these letters. The waw had to be preceded by dhamma, like nu. This is mad tabi'i, and the ya has to be preceded by kasra, like hi, and the alif has to be preceded by fatha, like ha. So the letters of mad tabi'i are way, which is waw, alif, ya, and the conditions are gathered in this word, nu, hi, ha. The condition of mad tabi'i and the letters are gathered in this word, but this is just the letters of mad tabi'i, and you do it for just two counts. For example, siqa, yaqulu. Al-muttasil, the second thing. So we'll build anything on mad tabi'i. You need to focus in mad tabi'i first, because we will build a lot of mad categories on mad tabi'i. المتصل is مد طبيعي followed by همزة in the same word, like السماء. See, here is مد طبيعي ألف and preceded by فتحة, but there is همزة in the same word, so you do it for five counts. السماء, and here is سوء, the same thing, and the count is like closing your finger or opening it, and it depends on the شيخ. You need to recite all of these and practice all of these rules with Sheikh. As-sama, su. Al-mad al-munfasil is disconnected mad. It's mad tabi'i followed by hamza, but in the next word, like Rabbi. This is ya mad, and before it there is kasra, and followed by hamza in the next word. So you do it for four counts. So mad tabi'i, you do it two. Mad muttasil is connected, you do it five. And mad munfasil is disconnected, you do it for جزاكم الله خيرا and let's get to practice. I'm going to highlight مد طبيعي منفصل and متصل here in this ayah. This is the last ayah from سورة البينة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. جزاؤهم عند ربهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه ذلك لمن خشي ربه. Okay, here is جزاؤهم مد طبيعي ألف مد and there is فتحة before it, so the condition is there and the Hamza is coming in the same words, so this is مد متصل five counts. جنات, this is ألف مد before it there is فتحة, مد طبيعي natural مد two counts. تجري, by the way, تجري is مد طبيعي as well. الأنهار, this is ألف مد and there is فتحة before it. خالدين, ألف مد there is فتحة before it, مد طبيعي, all of this is مد طبيعي. فيها أبدا, this is disconnected مد because there is مد طبيعي and there is همزة in the next word, so this is four counts. I'm just going to highlight some rules that we've studied before. عند is إخفاء نون ساكنة. ربهم جنات is إظهار ميم ساكنة. جنات is نون with شدة two counts. عد is قلقلة bouncy. عدن تجري إخفاء تنوين followed by تاء. تجري جيم is قلقلة. من تحتها نون ساكنة followed by تاء is إخفاء two counts. من تحتها الأنهار خالدين the highest level of heaviness. خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم نون ساكنة followed by ها, so this is إظهار making it clear with no غنة. ورضوا عن heavy letter and عن the same thing like عنهم نون ساكنة followed by ها, so this is إظهار. ذلك, this is مد طبيعي by the way and then the letter. لمن خشية نون ساكنة followed by a throw letter which is from the six letters of إظهار. طيب أن ربه, here is سكون عارض, you stop on ها, you give it سكون, جزاكم الله خيرا. And your homework إن شاء الله is to watch مد طبيعي منفصل and متصل, let's say سورة الليل. This is إن شاء الله your homework is to do مد طبيعي, مد منفصل or مد متصل in سورة الليل, السورة number 92. جزاكم الله خيرا, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.